Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zollotech, and watchOS 9 was released to the public today. We've been waiting for this along with iOS 16, and iOS 16 is required to use watchOS 9. Now watchOS 9 is available for all supported devices, which means Apple Watch Series 4 up to the Apple Watch Ultra. This year they've dropped support for the Apple Watch Series 3, so they'll no longer get the latest features and updates. And this update, like I said, is available everywhere around the world, and this is fairly large when you go to install this, so it will take some time, and just give yourself plenty of time when you actually go to install this. Now let's talk about what's new. Now the first thing is new watch faces. If we scroll over here, you'll see here's the first new watch face. It's called Metropolitan. As we scroll through with the digital crown, you'll see the numbers stretch and sort of expand or contract based on which way we're scrolling. Of course, you can customize the colors and the complications. The next one you'll see here is astronomy. Now we've had astronomy for a little while, but this time around it updates our location with a little green dot. And as we rotate the digital crown, you can see the time of day as it changes. And also it now displays the current cloud coverage and a star map. So this will be updated based on cloud coverage across the world. Scroll over to the next one, and this one is called Playtime. This is a new updated face, more for kids, but if we tap on the numbers, you'll see they jump back. And if we rotate the digital crown, you can see the different shapes move around. So nothing huge there, but it's a nice little playful one. If we scroll over to the next, this one is called Lunar. It tracks the moon phases and can be customized to Hebrew, Islamic, or Chinese calendars. So as we rotate the digital crown, you can see the calendar change with the moon phases and more. Scroll over to the next, and this is Portrait. Now we've had Portrait for a little while, but now it's been updated to support dogs as well as cats. And then if we customize it, you can change the background tinting. So not only the font and complications, but if we go back over here to style, you can change the tint in the background, similar to what we can do with wallpaper on iOS 16. They've also updated a bunch of your favorite watch faces as well, such as Modular. You can now change the background color. You'll see this one is sort of a reddish pink color. So let's go back out. We'll press and hold, go to edit, and you can see the background changes based on what you'd like. So if you want a colorful background, then you can go through all your different colors to match your band. So lots of different updates there. And then also they've updated a bunch of other watch faces with rich complications, and then Modular Compact, Modular and Extra Large faces now allow you to customize the background colors and have Chinese script options. Also Nike watch faces have been added. So if we scroll down, we've had Nike watch faces for a while, but not available to other watches. So if we scroll down in our Apple Watch app, you'll see we have Nike Analog, Nike Bounce, Nike Compact, Nike Digital, Nike Hybrid. So those are options. If you want to use those, they're available now. Now notifications pop in from the top now, similar to what we have with the iPhone. So if maybe I change a status on my home app, we'll give it a moment and it should pop in from the top. Give it just a second to update. And you can see there's the notification. You can tap on it to see it full screen. So they've changed the way this looks in watchOS 9. The Compass app gets a complete redesign thanks to the Apple Watch Ultra. You'll see I have it as a complication here on my watch face, but it also has a new icon for the overall compass itself in your apps. If we go into it, you'll see that it looks completely different. And we have some new options as well, depending on your device. So on the Apple Watch Series 7 that I'm using here, we have the backtrack option. And if we tap on this complication, you'll see that it says start backtrack. Apple Watch can record your route in case you get lost. It will actually mark waypoints along your way to help you get back to where you started. Additionally, we have an option here to show you your exact location. Tap on it, and it will show you not only a map, but also give you your latitude and longitude as you scroll down. In the upper left, we have some options here that show the overall compass itself. So you'll see south and then the little compass dial, our latitude and longitude again. So all of that has been updated for the compass, which is a much nicer version. It seems to work a little better for me also. Now this time around, Apple Watch prioritizes what apps you use most. So maybe you want to go into an app that you've used recently. We can press the button here and it will put what you've used most at the top. So I've been in settings a lot for this video, Compass and more. So you can easily get through your different apps and go into what you're using the most. There's also an all new low power mode. So if we go into our control center here, tap on our percentage for the battery, you'll see here we have low power mode. So no longer power reserve, but a low power mode. If we tap on it to turn it on, it actually warns us that it saves battery life by turning off always on display and limiting the sensors as well as the cellular and Wi-Fi connections of your Apple Watch. So this isn't something you want to use regularly as it turns off a lot of features. It says notifications may be delayed and emergency alerts may not arrive. This will turn off features such as background heart rate measurements, heart rate notifications, irregular rhythm notifications, and blood oxygen measurements. So if you want to use this just to get you to where you can get to a charger, you can turn it on or turn it on for a duration with turn on four. Otherwise, I wouldn't regularly use this, but it's nice that there's that option to get you to where you can get to a charger. WatchOS 9 changes the interface for powering off your watch. So press and hold the side button. And now you'll see we have medical ID, compass backtrack, or emergency call. The power button is now in the upper right. Tap on the power button, and now you can power off your watch. Also, they've changed the interaction for exiting maybe sleep mode or also ejecting water. So maybe you went for a swim, you need to get water out of the watch, press the button. Instead of rotating the digital crown now, you now press and hold it. So you'll see the interaction's a little bit different there. And they've just changed that up a little bit. Also, with the addition of iOS 16 and watchOS 9, Apple has updated focus modes. They've made it simpler to set up on the iPhone, but they've also added the addition to be able to change your wallpaper here and then change your watch face at the same time based off your focus mode. So if we go into settings and then focus, maybe we'll select gaming. Under gaming, of course, we can choose people and apps, and you'll see that we have a watch face here. So we can change this, edit it to whatever we'd like. If we want to change it during gaming, we can do that. Whatever we'd like, we can change it. Then when we go into a different focus mode, it should change along with it. However, I have found that this initially is quite buggy. So we'll see if it actually works here. It changed on the iPhone, but so far hasn't changed on the watch. Workouts this year get some significant upgrades. So if we go into workout, scroll down, go to outdoor run, give it just a moment to count down so it begins, you'll see that the view is all new. We have our rolling mile and average pace. We also have heart rate zones, and these will let us know and alert us on our wrist as we enter different zones. We'll go to the next one. You'll see we have split pace, and then below that we have elevation gained. Again, go down one more and we have our activity rings with move, exercise, and stand. So they've redesigned this to make it a little bit easier to view. And also later this year, we'll have more for this, such as pacing based on what we've done before. So if we regularly have a run or cycling path that we do, we can see if we're on the same pace or beating that pace. So you can kind of compete against yourself. There's also a pacing app that will let you know if you're on pace while you're running regularly. So it will let you know if you're ahead of that pace or behind it. Now you can also see running power now to stay consistent. And also it now measures additional things such as stride length, ground contact time, vertical oscillation to see how efficiently you run. You can see that in your health app. And you'll see all of that data in your health app. And of course, these aren't real workouts, as I was just showing you an example, but you can see more information about your heart rate and more here as it measures things such as stride length and more. Within the workout app, if we scroll all the way down, we can add a custom workout. So go into add workout, and then maybe we'll just pick basketball. And then it's an open goal, go into the three dots, and we can create a workout. Create that workout based off what you want with custom options. So add a warm up, add a cool down, or more based on what type of workout you're actually doing. There's also an option now for triathletes. So if we go in back to our workouts, you can see we have a new multi-sport triathlon. So this can actually transition on its own, knowing that you're doing a triathlon, and it'll switch between swimming, biking, and running automatically. So you have some options in here, of course, and you can change it based on what you'd like. So swim and bike, or bike and run, and more. So these have all been updated in the workouts app, and I think it'll be super helpful for those that use this regularly. Also, if you swim, you can now measure kickboard in a pool as a new stroke type. So a lot of different information here, a lot of different workout updates, and a lot more information kept overall in the health app. They've also added something else to the health app, or you can see it on your watch. So if we scroll up in our apps here, you'll see that we now have medications. Medications is a way to track your medications. I just added a generic one here, but you can see there's medication. It tells me when I should take it, and you can log that medication as you take it. So maybe you want to take this one. You can see the amount and then log that you've actually taken it. You can have it set reminders as well, and it will tell you interactions between different medications. And you can either set them here or you can set them in the health app where you can add a medication. So if we go into health, go down to browse, go to medications. You can add a medication here, and as you add them, it will show you different interactions. So it's a really nice update to the health app that it reminds you on the watch as well. Additionally, with the health app, it now gives more information about sleep. So if we go into sleep, if you're using it to monitor sleep overall, there's more sleep data this time around. So it tells you when you're awake, it measures your REM sleep, or REM sleep, or core and deep. So you'll see percentages, how long you were in those different sleep modes, and it measures all of that information just using the same watch you've always used. So it's just giving you more data about how you sleep overall. There's also comparison charts here that will compare your heart rate, respiratory rate, and wrist temperature if you have one of the new Apple Watch Series 8 or Ultras that measures temperature. So it will compare that over time as you sleep. So it's really nice that they've updated this. Also in health, under heart, we now have an AFib history option. So you'll see AFib history. Under AFib history, you can set this up if you have a history of AFib or you just want to monitor it overall. It can now look for that regularly and let you know if it thinks there's an issue so you can contact your health provider. You can also share a PDF with a doctor if you have an AFib history here set up. And then also there's a new cardio recovery metric estimated by Apple Watch that's here as well. So lots of different heart updates, workouts, and more. Apple Watch this year gets additional accessibility updates. We had some big ones before with gestures and more. This year we have Bluetooth keyboard pairing with Apple Watch, so you can do that if you want to use that. You also have more gestures. So if we go into our Apple Watch and then go to our accessibility on the app, you'll see here where we have accessibility, we can turn on quick actions and assistive touch. So a quick action is on here. There we go. And let's go into assistive touch. We'll turn that on. And we have hand gestures. Under hand gestures, we have a new double pinch option to start a workout or take a photo. You also have expanded quick actions with assistive touch for play and pause and now playing. Additionally, pause and resume in workout, take a photo using camera remote, and toggle between map views and turn-by-turn directions in maps. Under accessibility options on iOS 16, you'll now have Apple Watch mirroring if you have a watch connected. So you'll see here, as long as it supports it, it will show up, turn it on, we'll give it a second to connect. Takes just a moment. And once it's connected, we can control our Apple Watch. So you'll see on the watch, it says it's connected. Press the button on the side. You can press the digital crown. You'll see we can go back and forth into our watch. We can scroll a little bit. And sometimes it's a little bit buggy, but we can go into different things. Again, go back and forth, go into our apps and more. So we have the option to use that from the iPhone if we want to do that. You can also control nearby devices on the iPhone as well, not just your Apple Watch. If we go back into our apps on the watch, you can see here, if we go into calendar, we can now add an event to the calendar. Tap the three dots in the bottom right and add an event. So add a new event, and we can finally do that from the watch before we had to use the iPhone. So you can set it up just like you would on the iPhone for an event for whatever day you'd choose. Also, reminders has been updated. So if we go back, go down to our reminders, go into that app. Within reminders, we can now edit a reminder. So you'll see before we didn't have that option. So you'll see here, I have a reminder here. We'll go into it and we can mark it as completed or edit it just like we can edit a calendar entry now. So again, set up the reminder, change the priority, flag it, and more. If we go into the podcasts app, within podcasts, if we scroll up, we now have a search option. We didn't have search before, but now we can search for our favorite podcast using the keyboard or our voice, depending on the watch you have, and then just play it from there. Also, podcasts will be available to kids using Family Setup with the different podcasts you allow. And when you're using Family Setup, third-party email support is now extended to Yahoo and Outlook for kids, and editing and sharing contact photos is now available under Family Sharing as well. And then coming later this year, you'll be able to share different keys for your home to unlock a door at your house if you have a digital key. And you'll be able to share hotel keys and more to Wallet. That'll be available to children or those that you have significantly under you that you're taking care of. Also within settings, depending on the language you have set, there's additional language support in watchOS 9. So language support includes French, German, Italian, Japanese, Portuguese, and Spanish, which will be on the Apple Watch Series 7 and later for some reason. It doesn't necessarily cover all of the other watches. Also in Fitness Plus, there's new trainer callouts for additional metrics and more compatibility with third-party TVs other than just Apple TV. So if you're using Fitness Plus, maybe going through a different workout, there'll be different callouts with more information about that. So maybe you're using the latest Fitness Plus workout, you'll see more information on whatever device you're using. Also, there's updates to privacy where health information has always been encrypted, but they've again reiterated this. And also now you'll be periodically reminded of what you're sharing. So if you're sharing health data, it will let you know that you're doing that just to make sure you want to do that. Also, support has been added for international roaming on cellular models on Apple Watch SE, Series 5 and later. So that's great with this particular watch. Included in watchOS 9 are additional security updates, and you can see those on Apple's security website as they update it. So anytime there's a new update, you can see it here. And even though watchOS 9 is out to the public, it still hasn't been updated on their website. But either way, you'll see that a little bit later, and I'll link it in the description. And if you're wondering if you should install watchOS 9 right away, this is the most stable of any of the betas when it was in beta. So compared to iOS 16, this has been really good. I had very few issues, especially with the most recent betas. So whether that be going into different apps such as Lumi that I have as my center of my complications here on my main watch face, or if you're just going into regular apps, switching between different things, it seems to be fast overall. Really had no issues with it as far as performance and stability, and battery life seems to be about the same as it always was. Of course, it's been on the whole time filming this video and is doing quite well. I took it off the charger this morning, and with the screen on the entire time, since about 9 a.m. off the charger, it's at 80%. Again, keep in mind the screen was on, I was filming this video, so it drained a little bit faster than normal, but it easily gets me through a day. Of course, the Apple Watch Ultra will get through even more. Otherwise, this seems to be a great update. Not huge updates compared to previous years or redesigns, but a very helpful update with workouts and more. If you haven't seen my iOS 16 video, I have a separate video that's an hour long going over every single feature and change in that as well. So be sure to check that out. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.